is, like you just told me how much they were worth the other day. And he still lives alone with his parents, so he's ready to go. Like, he's quite a catch. Dave, you know how they. Alright, this is a natural behaviour they do out in the wild. One of their favourite animals to pick off is flying foxes. They'll breach above the water, often in their thousands, the whole colony, hanging upside down from the branch of a tree. Whilst they're having a nap, so that works out well for crocodiles. So they come vertically straight up and out once he's ready to go. And as you can see, he angles his head up, he gets his power from his tail. Back around the front one. It looks a whole lot bigger from here too. And some of our crocodiles get as high as this top rail here. Just lean down a bit closer. Oh. I think you got it. Yep. Alright, the lesson there is very simple. It's just don't climb out on anything which overhangs the water.
So croc territory isn't here in the Sunshine Coast. It's about 600 kilometres north in a place called Rockhampton, across the top of Australia and down to Broome in Western Australia. The crocs much prefer to reside in the warmer waters.
Alright, let's get in our land one more time so we can just show you how slow thanks, Dave, make you angry. Just show you that they're not so fast away from the water's edge. Have a good seat. I can actually take a seat here, as long as I keep an eye on him. And he knows, and I know, that I can actually get up out of the way and get away quicker than when he can come forwards. So he makes no attempt there. That's because he's too big and too bulky. Once they're large enough to see us as prey, away from the water's edge, not so fast. He's got to start dragging that tail behind him. It's acting like a dead weight. It's slowing him down. And in the water, they go about the cruising speed of a dolphin over short distances.